This is my railroad, and I'm proud of it. Yes, there's something about a railroad, and something about the railroaders who keep it running. Men and women working together and sharing a common pride, knowing how to run their railroad. To a passenger, the railroad is a ticket home or a ticket to adventure, to new scenes passing by the window, or to places well remembered. A heritage from the past, a service to the present, a dream for the future still to come.
The train station is certainly one jewel. All you have to do is look at that building, and there aren't many buildings around like that anymore. The combination of the colors of the rocks, the light-colored granite mixed in with the darker-colored granite, I mean, it has, to me, what's like a Richardson Romanesque look, but it's the combination of sort of the rugged stone and the combinations of colors and the curved Roman arches on the outside. On the inside, the wonderful wooden panel ceiling called the oculus, which is really distinctive. But anybody who hasn't been in the train station should walk inside just to take a look up at the ceiling. It's like a fairly large dome ceiling with wonderfully restored dark wood paneling. Now, Dwight McCarron, I am the head of the Stoughton Historical Society. I'm in my 20th year, approaching the 20th year of that. Preserving the worthwhile past is our motto. So some of it is intangible objects, because we're also a museum. The other part are maps, documents, newspapers. We preserve it, and we discuss it, and we try and communicate it to the community. We're both interested in teaching you what we know about Stoughton, what we've saved, but many of our resources come from people who, in their attic or from their own memories, contribute things to us. We certainly appreciate getting a crack at looking at that stuff. We may not save all of it, but we will preserve the worthwhile past as we can. Some people are interested in reminiscing their high school years and who played on the football team, or coming and looking at the yearbook of who their classmates were. I did not grow up in Stoughton, so my children did. But in my case, I don't have high school memories to reminisce about, but I've gone further back. To be able to compete with the townies, I have to know the old history better than they do, and I do. One of the changes I think that's happened in Stoughton over time is just how many more houses there are. I mean, we have aerial views of the town from 1953, and I'm amazed when I look over tracts of land that were woods then or fields are now full of houses. Well, the railroad first came to Stoughton in 1845. But that train station wasn't built until 1888, so there were three earlier stations made out of wood. But then the Old Colony Railroad, the Boston and Providence Railroad, decided that they would build a terminal station and put all that money into the stone and the wonderful architecture that you see in it. Charles Brigham, I believe, was the man who designed it, who was a reasonably famous architect at the time. What's distinctive about it is its clock tower, because it was a terminal station. It was the end of the line for that particular part of the railroad. I'm not an expert on the gears. I know that they were repaired at one point, but you had to go in there and reset them every so often. Then at some point, the gears jammed again, and unfortunately, the clock has not worked for some time. So I think there are only four or five train stations in Massachusetts that had these towers. And the rest of them have all been demolished. So this, to my knowledge, this is the only train station left that has the bell tower still with it. The stone was taken from a quarry up on West Street, which if you go to the Bird Street Conservation Area, you can actually see the hole that the stone was taken out of by local quarryman Myron Gilbert to build that train station. So that's also what makes it special to me, too, that the stone the stone that built it came from just up the street. It was probably drawn by oxen and horses and carts back in 1888. The soldiers who left for the war and came back, sometimes in coffins, went from that train station. Well, it was a waiting room, and the trains for a century were kind of the central focus of the community. So the focus of the activity in town often centered around the trains, and then the trolleys, which came off and were usually owned by separate companies. But so before the real rise of the automobile after World War I, I mean, trains and trolleys were the center of how one got around. Erastus Smith, whose diary we have, would take the train in 1850, occasionally in town. They called it taking the cars. And I believe it cost 5 cents then. He could go in town and see the town. But his father, when he would go into Boston, would actually take a horse and cart in to carry the hoops that he made. So it was a certain expense that people who were living close to the edge, the manufacturers like Ames would use the train. In fact, that was the reason the train line was first built in Northeastern, extended beyond Stoughton in 1855. Thousands and thousands of Ames shovels were being produced there, and to have the train line go right to it was a benefit to everyone.
Supplies came to Stoughton from the train as well, out of Boston. And then the passenger cars took people back. So it served a dual purpose, as that it was bringing goods in and out of Stoughton, as well as serving as a stop to go to Boston. I remember coming up to this building when I was a kid, shining shoes, to people that were waiting for the train, for about 10 to 25 cents, depending if they gave you a tip. People stuck together, people that knew each other, lived together. They went to the same church, they went to the same general store. We had that in Stoughton years ago. My name is Joseph McCriskey, and I am currently sit on the select board. I was born in the town of Stoughton in 1961. And since then, at the age of 62, I have been honored to serve as a volunteer in our community. This town was founded in 1726. This is the home to the Suffolk Resolves, which many may not know. The Suffolk Resolves were the draft of what became the Declaration of Independence. And they were drafted in Stoughton at Doty's Tavern, which is now in the town of Canton. In this town, we only have our town hall and our train station as the defining buildings in downtown. This building is community. This building has served the community. It's a staple, it's a landmark, it's a meeting place. It marks a place and time which allows people to see where we were and where we are now. So for a moment, you can really take somebody out of the humdrum world, bring them in here and take them away from reality for a little bit and give them a memory.
It was 1924 when the train was flying through Stoughton northbound, and two villains, young men who in search of adventure had put railroad spikes on the track, see what would happen. Well, what happened is the train derailed and plowed right into the railroad station, knocking out one of the walls. Fortunately, there weren't many people in the station at the time because there weren't many people waiting for that boat train. In fact, I'm not sure the train was even going to stop. One of the interesting anecdotes is there were a couple women in the ladies' room who were trapped. They weren't hurt, but they were trapped and had to open the windows to get out. And well, it turned out in their own houses, they did not have running water and bathrooms, so they had outhouses. And a certain time of day, they would come down and use the running water in the toilets at the railroad station. But it was a miracle no one was hurt, but the station was greatly damaged, and it was really quite a mess. They obviously had to bring in other equipment to get the locomotive righted and pull it out of here. And I don't know what consequences those boys suffered. I don't think they ever was charged with anything in court, but it was, we dodged a bullet on that one.
We didn't have hydraulic lifts in the early 1900s. So this was done with crank machines and leverage and so forth, and moving, what could have been a 60-ton locomotive. So you think, what a monumental task. And out there is Chief Banston, Richard Banston, the only chief that served as both police and fire chief at one time. He looks like he is the protector, that he is, I'm in charge right now. Those were the people that make Stoughton what it is today. It was a huge effort, you know, back in the 70s when the people of this town came together and raised the money to totally refurbish this building.
They were going to tear it down, you know, in the 1960s because the plan was, given Stoughton's traffic problems, to run Route 27 right through where the train station is. There wasn't an appreciation of it as a historic building, and it was starting to deteriorate, and suddenly it seemed like it was in the way. And it was really that move to get rid of the train station that spurred the Historical Society into saving that building. And so that led to the whole process by which it was declared a national landmark in 1974. We have two places on the National Register, the train station and this building here, the Lucius Clapp. But because something is on the historical register doesn't mean it doesn't rot or it doesn't fall in if you don't take care of it. A lot of blood, sweat, and tears went into restoring that building, which was a wreck at the time. Part of the reason it fell in disrepair after this wonderful restoration took place, though, was that the MBTA began to charge more and more for liability insurance for the people who parked outside. And at some point, the fee got to be so high that the town manager made a decision, okay, we're not paying that fee anymore, and we'll give the building back to the MBTA. But there was no one day-to-day taking care of the building or making sure that it was okay. So like anything, it deteriorated again.
When that state agency took possession, they made a commitment that they would keep it in the condition they received it in. They failed miserably. And it put the town in an uneasy position to now have to fix what they didn't. That's behind us now. You know, it's in the rearview mirror. And, you know, they say rearview mirrors are great, but you never need to look at them when you're moving forward. Right now, the main thing to get done is to get the heat up and running, which it's not yet. Because the age of the building, it needs different fixtures to do that. It's not as simple as just coming in and putting in a gas line. It's an old building. You're going through 12-inch block in some cases. We actually did the capping, which you'll see in the basement, a piece of ornate brasswork that was done with the original building. They recreated the original that you can't tell the difference of the old stuff to the new stuff. So we kept the architectural integrity in 100% intact. We have a glass overlook that's upstairs, a skylight that actually, when you open up, fills into this room that we're sitting in. And it brings light in from the ceiling. Now, it's a bunch of light because it's just nothing but glass up there. And it's not a flat one, but it's actually raised from the roof and peaked. So it attracts light from both sides. And then we've got electricity restored. We now have a water line back reinstored. So that's why we're going out and we're asking for our state partners, whatever, the Department of Transportation, Congress, what can you do through Federal Rail? What can the MBTA do? Because they're our partner. We sit on the rail here.
The job of town government and us is to, in each individual decision, decide, okay, is this something we want to preserve? How much money are we willing to spend on it? But the larger repairs are basically being paid for by CPC or applications to the Community Preservation Commission.
Mark Zamanian, chair of the Community Preservation Committee and the Stoughton Redevelopment Authority. I think there's a willingness to see this building function. We have a very small window right now, though.
We were hoping that there'd still be access for the community to use the building for certain events.
We're not lacking for ideas. We just have to find one that we can get behind and continue on with the legacy of our volunteers from the 1970s. Thank you.
This is and could be used for, again, once it's up and running, to allow patrons of the MBTA to come inside, stay warm in the winter or on a rainy day, you know, be here out of the elements. And I think it would be better served as being a place, you know, for the community, bringing the community together. Right now, there's just so many things we could do here. Simple things, senior dinners. Have nonprofits come in and fund a dinner for senior citizens to come here, be in a building that they remember from when they were a youth in Stoughton.
Part of the last movie of Little Women came and used the Stoughton train station for a day or two, and they had put a sign out that said Concord Railroad Station. So It does have potential to be used for things like that.
We have civic groups that talk about different projects. Bring them here. We have architecture groups, people that are into architecture, that can have meetings here. And I think that we're going to be able to meet the needs of everybody in this community. You know, I mean, there's so many people that need a place to go. This can be that building. This can be the building that's non-political. Doesn't matter what you stand for, who you stand for. You come here and you're a part of the community.
You could argue that at the time that train station was built was in some ways the golden age of Stoughton. We created some historic community buildings. I mean, in some sense, they reflect a special part of our past, but I think you need a couple examples around town where you do preserve, as we say, the worthwhile past.
If we forget the past, we lose it. What did somebody in 1888 see that they thought was worthy of putting a train station here? That's what we're trying to do now, is to bring this building back to the life that it once had.
Well, given the fact that the town has made a commitment to it, I mean, I think it will be standing long before you and I have passed this veil of tears. But on the other hand, given the cycles of history, you never know. Because things change that you don't think will change. Sometimes it takes you 10 or 20 years to sort out. But as far as I would predict, I think it will last another 135 years. It's owned by the town of Stoughton. And so its upkeep is now the responsibility of the town of Stoughton. So the question is what we're going to do with it. And we're working on that. Want to join the Historical Society? We're at 6 Park Street, and we have a quarterly newsletter that comes out.
I'd be remiss that I wouldn't say that we can always use people in town meeting, and if somebody wants to join and run for town meeting, it's a very simple process. Look me up and I'll help you out, because it is the greatest feeling in the world.